I've had a couple of Philips Hue owners recently complain that I shouldn't be comparing cheap alternatives such as this bulb from Gosund to the Philips Hue equivalents. What should I compare them to? This potato?
This potato is everything.
Of course I'm going to compare things to Philips Hue. They're the market leaders, you maniac! Thanks to Gosund for sponsoring today's video and sending me some of their smart home gear. Today, I will be comparing it to various root vegetables so that I don't offend anybody's delicate sensibilities. Good! Just kidding. I will be comparing all of these products to Philips Hue, and you can suck my balls.
He just said he was like, oh, I hate Bohemian!
Gosund are another manufacturer who use the Tuya Smart Life platform. So if you already have a bunch of Wi-Fi gear that uses the Smart Life app, then you can add these products to your existing lineup for a ridiculously low price tag. Today's show features their preposterously cheap bulbs, their ludicrously cheap plug sockets, and their unbelievably cute nightlight.
I noticed he didn't say the nightlight was cheap, then he said the nightlight was cute. I bet it's expensive.
It's £22.99. This nightlight is a Wi-Fi-based LED table lamp with touch-sensitive control that works with Google Home and She That Should Not Be Named for voice control, and at just 23 quid, this thing has no right being anywhere near as good as it is. The closest thing I can find from Philips Hue is this glowing blob. And I can't bring myself to buy it because it's over £100 and can't even do colour. The Philips Wellner lamp is 800 lumens, primarily because it's just a Philips Hue 800 lumen bulb in a glass blob. If the Philips Hue bulb costs £14 and the overall product costs £102, it means... It's a massive bloody ripoff! It's a £100 bulb in a bulb. It does literally nothing. It's a bulb, right? A smart home bulb in a bowl. That's it! The Gosund bedside table lamp, however, has touch-sensitive controls that allow you to double-tap it to turn it on and off. It also has touch-sensitive control to switch between colour and white, or to dial in one of seven colours and adjust its brightness. £23. 23 quid. According to their Amazon page, in special moments, you can choose the appropriate brightness to render the scene atmosphere. What kind of special moments would be illuminated by a bedside lamp? It's a simple blend of smart home voice control or smart home giving it a little smack. I won't stand for this smut! Unsubscribe! At £22, the Philips Hue plug sockets are not the worst price in the world. I'd pay that. Of course I wouldn't, because the Gosund equivalent is £18 for two. Don't get me wrong, at £22 I actually think the Philips Hue smart plug is pretty decent. It's got a button conveniently located on the top, which is actually quite unusual. They're normally located on the side of these things. And it's got Apple HomeKit support if you have a Philips Hue bridge. If you're an Apple HomeKit user, I actually recommend this plug. If you're willing to buy the Hue bridge as well, then you're on a fairly slippery slope into Huedom. If you don't want the Philips Hue bridge, then Philips actually boast that this has Bluetooth support as well. This means that you could control it using your mobile phone, as long as your mobile phone is within Bluetooth range of that socket. Great. This means that there's no ability to control it with your voice, there's no ability to control it if you're not in your house, there's basically no ability to control it unless you want to get the app out of your pocket and switch the plug socket on and off with that. So it's kind of pointless. It's kind of like giving Luke Skywalker the plans to the Death Star and then telling him he can only blow up one bathroom. Both devices have a maximum amperage of 13 amps, and so what it really comes down to, if you're not an Apple HomeKit user, is whether or not you want to give twice the amount of money to the Emperor for literally no reason.
Alexa, turn the plug sockets on.
Doing your bidding, my master.
Good. plug sockets from Philips Hue. You will join us or you will die.
Get to the point. Other than Apple HomeKit, the Gosund plug sockets have all of the exact same functionality as the Philips Hue equivalents. This includes timers, schedules, voice support for Google Home and She That Should Not Be Named, and an app to control them manually. This is my lux meter, and it has the power to shut trolls up by proving that one bulb is brighter than another. I've pit the Gosund bulb against the Philips Hue equivalent for a variety of colours. And as we all know, Philips Hue can't do purple.
Blue? No, purple. Blue? No, purple. Blue? Purple! How about a slightly pinky blue? Purple! 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 Blue?
Both bulbs light the room a very similar amount at their brightest possible setting, but the Gosund is marginally brighter. They both also have a very different idea of what white should look like. So if you have a preference on white temperature, this could be a deciding factor because the Gosund bulb only does one temperature of white at this price tag. For colours, there is actually very little difference between the bulbs. The Gosund bulb is of course way cheaper than the Philips Hue equivalent, but it would be wrong of me not to state which areas the Philips Hue wins out in, and the Philips Hue bulb is the clear winner when it comes to reds.
Paul Hibbert just declared Hue the winner for something I don't believe in!
Hue is better at reds. It's also three times the price. The Gosund bulbs are some of the cheapest on the market. They shouldn't be giving Philips Hue a run for their money on any colour setting, and they actually are brighter for whites. This is a total embarrassment to Philips Hue.
Let the hate run through you, young Skywalker. Lord Vader, fetch the cough syrup.
If you're an Apple HomeKit user, perhaps Philips is the best option. There are ways to get the Gosund stuff, and in fact any other Tuya Smart Life based product to work with Apple HomeKit using something called Homebridge. This would involve having a PC or a Raspberry Pi act as the conduit between the two devices. If that's something you're interested in, you should totally do it. It will save you a whole bunch of money. If you're literally anybody else, like using Google Home or She That Should Not Be Named, then this is a no-brainer. It is so much cheaper. Unless you're interested in having a red light on all the time, that would be weird, then the Gosund stuff is the obvious choice. If you're interested in any of the products you've seen today, my personal favorite being this awesome nightlight, there are links in the description as to where you can buy those things. On an unrelated note, I wanted to ask Amazon's former CEO and current chairman Jeff Bezos a question. Now that you've tripled in profits because of a deadly virus sweeping the planet, are you going to give that money back to the people and, you know, invest it in COVID charities and that sort of thing? Or are you going to buy yourself a massive multi-million pound mega yacht and build yourself a spaceship so that you can put you and your brother into space for 10 minutes?
Rockets and yachts!
Thought so. In the meantime, I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, please give it a thumbs up. That'll tell YouTube's algorithms it was a good video and more people should see it. If you want to see some more of this guy, hit that subscribe button and ding that bell. If you ding the bell, it lets YouTube know that you want to be notified when I upload videos. These incredible people here are my patrons from Patreon. And seriously, without them, I would have given up on this a long time ago. I would still be doing the day job and I would be knackered or dead, probably. If you want to be one of those guys, you can do that at either Patreon or buy me a one-off beer at PayPal. And either way, I would genuinely love you forever. These are my Facebooks and my Twitters and my Instagrams. Come and hang out there and we can be best friends. See you next time. As long as your phone is in Bluetooth range of the socket. This means, of course, that there's no bulbs such as this cheap alternative from Gosund. It's got the button conveniently
rockets and yachts.